I'm Ms. Wright, and I teach at Oakstead Elementary. I teach a third grade classroom. What you have seen in my lesson are students taking notes about texts that they read. They did a close and careful read of a text, and what that means is that they read the text carefully for a second time to gather deeper understanding and information. They use notes to help them understand in a deeper way. Some kids like to draw pictures or use codes. They'll make connections to the text, and what I really like about it is that it lets me see their thinking while I walk around. I can look at the things that they're writing down or the things that they're typing, and right away I can see the thoughts that are going on inside of their mind as they're reading. Today we are going to show how we annotate our text, and we're going to take notes inside of our text to help us find an answer to a question. We were reading about a problem with butterflies in Costa Rica, and you are going to close and careful read your text so that you can find parts of the solution. Before we start our work, I want to review what annotating is. So, first, I want you to watch me. After I go over what annotating is, you're going to teach your partner. Are you ready? Yeah. Mirror, start.
Mirror, start.
Annotating?
Annotating.
Is?
Is.
When you take notes?
When you take notes.
In the text?
In the text.
It shows your thinking?
Shows your thinking.
Sometimes it shows how you connect to a story.
It shows parts that you like.
Things you had a question about?
Or
you wondered? The teacher will know. And be so excited. When she sees you annotating. She'll know. Because she'll see pictures,
words,
text codes,
and she'll tell you,
rock.
You rock.
Mirror, stop.
Mirror, stop.
Teach.
Why we annotate is because so we can help us learn and just write our own thoughts. That's what annotating is.
Students need to learn these skills just as part of helping them become critical thinkers. We annotate not only in reading, but we annotate all the time during class. And I show my students how this is something that I do when I go to a meeting or I'm giving information. I actually will show them some of the notes that I have, and I'll say, look, adults do this too. You need to know how to read something and think about it to help you understand. I use some of strategies called whole brain teaching, and that uses movements and repetition. Sometimes I'll use part of a song and I'll say noun and noun, 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 and they'll say names of person, place, or thing. It's just a way to get their attention instead of waiting or, you know, standing up there quietly. It's just more interesting and exciting. Use your energy to get those notes down. Put what you're connecting to. Did you read the caption? That's what you were thinking? So I would add that to your thoughts there, that it looks really neat.
Do their kind of like SpongeBob, how overnight the caterpillar turned into the butterfly when it was in the pupa. Remember? When they and then they said, it ate wormy.
Oh, yeah.
I found a connection to SpongeBob.
We had a connection up here to SpongeBob. We had some diagrams back here to help show what their text was saying. Some people drew the life cycle out to help them understand the parts of the butterfly that they were reading about, which I thought was a really smart thing to do. I like to have my students take their notes and actually create something with it, so it takes their thinking even to a further level. And so right now they're making an iMovie, and they're able to be creative and show me with evidence from the text and their own thoughts that they were able to process information and put it together. I should see.
Everyone
taking turns.
I should see
the text
and
your notes
in
your iMovie.
In your iMovie.
You can have fun.
You can work together.
And I can't wait to see your work.
Writing on a paper is really boring. All you do is use a pencil and you just write, but with iMovie, it's like really fun because it plays music while you're showing your information and pictures.
And iMovie is also fun because you can go on Google and like type up pictures that we already were learning about, and then you could put the pictures in there to show like real evidence that you found out the answer.